The Moto G6 Plus costs just 269 quid here in the UK, yet it offers a reasonably premium all-round experience. The question is, how does it hold up against the really, really premium flagship phones which can cost two or even three times as much? We decided to find out. For this little experiment, we decided to put the Moto G6 Plus up against three of the best Android flagships around: Sony's Xperia XZ2, Huawei's very shiny and sexy P20, and Google's mighty Pixel 2 XL. First of all, we took a look at design, and all four of these smartphones have a very unique flavour indeed. Glass is of course massively in fashion in 2018, and all of these phones sport a glass backend with the exception of the Pixel 2 XL, which sports a combination glass and metal. The look of the bunch, in our opinion, is Huawei's P20. It's absolutely stunning with that gradient design, which really throws out a rainbow of colours. That said, we also love Sony's fresh new mobile design language for its Xperia XZ2 with that lovely curvaceous finish. The Moto G6 Plus rocks a Corning Gorilla Glass 3 finish, so it's nice and durable and also looks suitably sleek. Those curvy corners and edges make for a comfortable grip, and it gives it a nice premium finish as well that certainly belies the £269 asking price. It's also splash-proof just like Huawei's P20, although admittedly Sony's Xperia XZ2 and Google's Pixel 2 XL are fully water-resistant. Next, we took a look at the screen tech, and once again the Moto G6 Plus holds up really well against its much more expensive brethren. That 5.9-inch Full HD Plus display is just as spacious and sharp as the Sony's Xperia XZ2 and Huawei's P20. Only the Pixel 2 XL stands out with its 6-inch Quad HD Plus screen, although to be honest, when you're watching a bit of Netflix, they all look just as detailed. You also get nice punchy colours on the G6 Plus as well with that built-in vibrant mode. Certainly if you're going to be watching a lot of movies on the go or simply browsing a lot of photo albums, you will be just as satisfied with the G6 Plus as you will those more expensive handsets. Next up, we decided to take a look at performance, and unfortunately that is an area where Motorola's little handset does lag behind the competition quite significantly. In this area, Sony's Xperia XZ2 is the king daddy right now with Qualcomm's fresh new Snapdragon 845 chipset. The Pixel 2 XL uses the slightly older Snapdragon 835 chipset, and Huawei uses its own Kirin processor. And as for the G6 Plus, it uses the Snapdragon 630, which is more of a mid-range platform. It was therefore no surprise whatsoever in our benchmark test to see Sony's little blower come out well up on top. In both Antutu and Geekbench, it absolutely ruled the roost, and unfortunately Motorola's Moto G6 Plus came in dead last. It was the same results as well for the graphical performance, no surprise at all. What does that actually mean for real world use? Well, to be honest, the Moto G6 Plus will still suit most users down to the ground. You get the occasional little bit of lag as you open up an app, but apart from that, it runs absolutely perfectly. And you can even do a bit of gaming on it as well. We tried a bit of PUBG on all four of these handsets. Now on the likes of Sony's Xperia XZ2, of course you can play in the high detail settings with a really, really smooth frame rate, although we did still see the occasional little dropped frame, possibly because it's an online game. But on the Moto G6 Plus, it was still perfectly playable. Admittedly, we had to scale back the graphics to the low detail settings, but once we were in the game, it still played just as smoothly. We had no trouble fragging a bunch of random strangers to our heart's delight. Now when it comes to the battery performance, there's generally much less of a gap between the budget handsets and the premium models. In fact, quite often the budget models are better because they use more efficient platforms. Sadly, that's not quite the case with the G6 Plus. It generally holds up pretty well, offering between a day and a half of real-world usage per charge. Sony's Xperia XZ2 is about the same, while Huawei's P20 generally reliably offers a day and a half. However, the granddaddy here is definitely Google's Pixel 2 XL, offering two full days of usage. That's something that's clearly shown in the benchmarking test that we did, which showed the Pixel 2 well ahead of the others. So sadly, the G6 Plus doesn't exactly shine in this area. In fact, if battery life is a priority and you want to go for a G6 handset, we'd recommend the G6 Play, which costs 100 quid less and yet boasts a much bigger battery, 4000 milliamp, offering up to 2 days of life just like Google's phone. Which brings us on to the final round, camera tech. The Moto G6 Plus rocks a dual lens snapper just like the Huawei P20. Meanwhile, the Google Pixel 2 XL and Sony's Xperia XZ2 suffice with a single lens setup. Now, all of these phones boast a wealth of features and toggles to play around with, and the G6 Plus definitely holds its own in this area. You get a portrait mode just like the other handsets, as well as a nifty little mode which brings your gallery to life when you're flicking through it. There's also the likes of slow motion and time lapse capture, as you would expect. Not to mention some manual controls if you want to take full control and get a very precise kind of shot. And the Moto G6 Plus actually offers quite a unique feature in the spot color mode as well, which isolates a single color and removes all the others for a black and white finish. It's the kind of shot that would make a wedding photographer cream in their pants. And when it came to everyday shots, we did notice a massive difference between the G6 Plus and these more premium handsets, especially considering the gulf in price difference. Admittedly, if you view back on a big screen and you look real close, the detail levels are not as strong as the more premium handsets. However, the G6 Plus really does handle HDR very, very well indeed. Strong contrast scenes come out really nicely. Unfortunately, low light is not quite as successful. This is where the others really show their superiority. Sony, Huawei and Google's phones all showed less grain and more richer colours. Still, the portrait mode is a lot more of a success. It works almost as well as the P20, with only minor blurring around the silhouettes. And when it comes to the video, all of these phones can shoot 4K Ultra HD resolution footage. Unfortunately, we did notice some audio issues on the G6 Plus when shooting outside. There was some slight electronic distortion, something that we also noticed on the Pixel 2 XL. The Xperia XZ2 is definitely still the winner here. Not only can you shoot 4K HDR footage, but also there's the brilliant super slow motion option, which shoots up to full HD at 960 frames per second. It's stunning. All the same for your basic home movies, to be honest, the Moto G6 Plus is perfectly shine. If you're just going to shoot a picture of your kids playing football or your cat going nuts in the kitchen, something like that, this will do the job. So that's our quick comparison of the G6 Plus with some much more expensive rival Androids. If you're not demanding the very best performance and features, then it's definitely worth a look. Don't forget to give us a subscribe and ding that notifications bell if you want to see more on the latest and greatest Android handsets to cover all price points. Thanks for watching, everyone. Cheers. Love you.